Fantastic. So it's going to be a wonderful session. It's going to be an interactive session. So I will tell you, know, I want you all to keep your camera on, video in on, on mode. You have to keep your camera on all the time because it's an interactive session. It's not a theory which you have to make a note. You don't have to make any note because the templates will be provided at the end of the training. Okay. So don't make any note. Just focus and learn. Okay. So this thing we will repeat again and again, and we will remember each and everything. Okay. From the day one. So Chetan, Mr. Chaitanya, your camera is not on. So you can switch it on. Mr. Chaitanya. Okay. So let's go one by one. Only three people have joined. So what we will do is first we'll start with the introduction. Okay. We'll start with the introduction and then we'll move it on to the actual topic. So who is starting the introduction first? Who will start the introduction? Mr. Suresh, can you start the introduction? Yeah. Clap for him. Start the introduction. Now Chaitanya is again gone. Yes, we can hear you. You can start your introduction. Are you able to hear me all? Not able to hear. Are you able to hear me clearly? Are you able to hear me? Type in the chat box if you are able to hear me clearly. I'm not able to hear you, Mr. Suresh. Are you all able to? I am hearing you. Suresh, yeah, you are able to hear. So start the introduction. You have to introduce yourself, tell your name, what you do. Okay. And what is, you know, what is your, you know, future plan? Not able to hear you. Not able to hear you. Oh, phone problem.
Good morning, sir. This is Chaitanya.
Yeah, Chaitanya. Yeah.
I am Chaitanya from Hyderabad. I went to fitness in the fitness this one.
Okay.
I went to business also.
Super. So, what is your future plan?
To set up a multiple businesses, which gives. Sources to many other people.
Okay. So who is the next? Clap for him. Who is next? Some background voice. Who is next? Who can introduce? Yeah, Parmeshwari, you can talk. You can talk. Your voice is breaking, I think. Your voice is breaking. Your voice is breaking. Your voice is breaking. Okay, next. Mr. Suresh, you are logging with the two devices. Yeah, Chetu Singhi, you can introduce yourself. Chetu Singhi.
Yeah. Hi, this is Mrs. Singhi. By profession, I'm a nutritionist, I'm a dietitian. So my main motto of joining this webinar or a public speaking course is, right now I'm taking a lot of webinars.
Okay.
So there are certain points I get fumbling up, or any eye contact is not there, and there are various people of different categories are there. So I got a little bit conscious for that, and sometimes it is it's elongated for so many hours. So along with that, I wanted to learn ki how to be in the sense that usme thoda sa lightness kaise lana hai, why not to go with all the theoretical part. That's why I just joined it.
Okay, super awesome. Clap for her. So we have to clap for whenever someone speaks, we have to clap because it's an interactive session. That's why all your video is on. Mr. Chaitanya, your video should be on. Mr. Chaitanya, you your video should be on. You have to face the people right now. Okay, so that's why you get habituated with the camera. You have to keep it on no matter what. Okay.
Now I am in driving.
Okay, okay. After driving, you can do it. So, Mrs. Parmeshwari, you can introduce yourself. You are in mute right now. Yeah, you can go ahead and introduce. I think your network problem.
Yes, yes, sir. I am Parmeshwari, working in LIC as a development officer since 10 years. I want to great public speaker and number one. This is my future plan. Number one development officer in the country. This is the, my future plan. I want to talk with the fearless and whatever in the mind, I want to talk freely in the public. That is the, my aim. That is why I joined this section.
Super awesome. Super awesome. Mind blowing. Actually, whatever you are saying, that's right. That is the main reason why you are here. And you know, you are going to learn a lot of things. It's going to blow your mind. And actually, when you implement, as I tell you, if you implement it, these are the scientific techniques which will blow your mind. And today, because the first day, it might go a little longer. Okay. But from tomorrow onwards, it will be becoming, you know, it will not take much time. But today, because the first day, you know, you are supposed to, you know, take more time. So before I jump in, you know, I would like to tell you, you know, just empty your mind. Okay. I always tell one story, but because this is the first day, it might take much of the time. Yeah, Mr. Suresh, please. You are muted. You are muted.
Yes. It is not unmuting. Now it is unmuting.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Thank you. Good morning, all. I am Suresh Loganathan from Tamil Nadu, in Erode place. I am a lawyer. I am doing network marketing for the past 10 years. I am an achiever in network marketing also. Now I am started doing training and public speaking workshop also. The 2-3 years. I want to upgrade myself. I saw Kaushik sir program in Facebook. So now I wanted to learn more from you. So I am joined this webinar. Thank you for the opportunity, for the wonderful.
So what? How you teach public speaking? I will take 1 or 2 minutes. How you teach public speaking?
No, I am in network marketing field. I want to motivate some people like that. No, from sales tips. Some people are down, they are not in the mind, they are weak for sales like that. No,
yeah,
we are from Tamil Nadu. So I am trying to motivate them, and I will give some tips and come up the stage, and stage fear pokkuradhukku sila velai ellam seivom. Now we are from Tamil Nadu, we are not comfortable in English. So kindly bear my English language.
No. English is not a problem. English is not a problem.
I know, but for the communication, we must know. No.
In public speaking, it's all about your body language. And I can see that you already have a good body language.
Okay.
So, and it's all also about the tone of the voice. So you already have. Come on. My daughter will, you know, want to introduce herself. Now you can introduce yourself.
Yeah, tell hi.
Your name and which class you are.
My name is Aradhya and I am third class.
Clap for her.
Hi.
Super. Hi. You can sit here. So she also, you know, she is very much interested in, you know, learning again and again and implementing it. Because she is a kid, she is not able to get 100% whatever, you know, I am able to train. So I'll keep beside me. Yes. So let's jump in. Okay. So first of all, generally I tell to, you know, empty your mind. Whatever you know about public speaking, because when you have come here, I know that you already know about public speaking. Otherwise, why you will come? What did public speaking people will think? Public speaking? I'm not a leader. But you already know, all of you already know about public speaking. That's what I know. So right now, for the 6 days, just forget about whatever you know. You just think that I don't know, I am a kid. Okay? And just learn whatever you are going to learn. Yes?
Yes.
So is it okay if I tell you my story, how this thing happens, how my journey about public speaking, so that you know you will be able to get more knowledge out of this. Okay? Can I tell you my journey about public speaking, how it started? So basically, I was in class 6. And I was in boarding school. So I went back to my, you know, in summer holidays, I went back to my grandpa house and with my mom and dad and stayed there. And, you know, I still remember I was in class 6 and I went there, and in the morning time, I was just playing carom with my cousin brothers and sisters. And I was having fun. I was, you know, just enjoying. And suddenly I hear a voice from the kitchen. My mom is saying, "Kaushal, go and bring milk." Okay. And actually I hated talking to stranger at that time. You know, whenever I will go out, people will ask me, "What is your father name? Which school you study?" and all that. So I wanted to avoid that. So I just tried to ignore that. Again, my mom, you know, shouted, "Kaushal, go and bring the milk." Again, I tried to ignore. Again, she told. Again, I ignored. Then she came with a stick. "I'm telling you again and again, and you're not listening to me." Then my grandma saved me, because I was very afraid to talk to strangers, okay? New people. My mind is always, what they will ask. If I go to the shopkeeper, he will ask my name and this and that. So after that incident, that day my grandma saved me, and it becomes more fearful for me that I am not able to go, okay, and talk to strangers. I hated speaking with strangers. And I was in class 9, and my class teacher nominated my name for the, you know, opening speech on 15th of August. Okay. And I was not even aware. So the moment I came to know that my name is got, you know, nominated for the opening speech, I got shocked. My God, what is this? I don't want to speak in front of 1,000 people, all those guests, so many other people. Okay. So then I went to the principal and said, no, take my name back. I don't want to speak in front of the opening speech. I don't want to go and speak on the stage in front of thousands of people. Then she said, no, we can't take the name back, because you are one of the brilliant students in our school. You have to go and speak. Now I'm thinking, what to do, man? I have to go and give a, you know, opening speech. And I don't want to do this. So, you know, my mind is, you know, thinking, what to do? But anyway, I was a brilliant student. I was a, you know, average good student. So what I thought is, you know, why not just remember all the speech? So I made a 10-line note and remember word by word, line by line. And the day 15th of August came, I was waiting for my turn. My heartbeat is going, you know, boom, boom, boom. And I have sweat on my face. And I went on the stage, okay, read, you know, letter by letter, and finished it and came back from the stage and went back to home. I didn't even stay there. Who is thinking what? Who is laughing? What my classmates are saying? And I went back to home. And after 1 hour, my cousin sister, you know, returned with a prize that you have got, you know, prize for your speech. And now I'm shocked. I'm thinking like, you know, what other will think? My class, you know, classmate will laugh at me. That how you are, you know, reading that line, and I'm getting a you know, gift out of this. So my mind is, you know, like, I have to learn public speaking now. So that day I decided to learn and started reading a lot of books on various, you know, human psychology, fear. I started doing research. More I read, more my fear increases. So now what I do, my mind is always thinking, you know, how to overcome this. And then, you know, I started working for corporate companies. While working for corporate companies, I came to know across this course, public speaking. And I got myself trained with the international trainers. And you will not believe, this course which I'm going to give you, within 2 days, I had this public speaking fear for almost for 15 to 20 years. And within 2 days, this fear is gone forever. And while trying to learn public speaking, I learned all the psychology. Because I am thinking, because I have shyness, I have fear, you know, So I'm reading hypnotism, I'm reading this, that, everything. NLP, I did NLP, neuro-linguistic programming from, you know, 3 to 4 time training I have took. So many training I took, but it has not gone. But this training, within 2 days, it is gone forever. Okay. So this is a, you know, that is the same training which I'm going to give you. It's very, very powerful. Okay. So if you just want to learn technique, you can learn. If you have, you know, kind of nervousness, fear, all that also will be gone. So I can understand that all of you are professional. You are not at that level. But I'm telling you, you bring a guy who cannot look into the, you know, eyes and speak. And within 2 days, he will go and speak in front of 10,000 people without any fear. Okay. So it is techniques and tools which you are going to learn. Okay. So ready for it? I hope you are ready.
Yeah, ready, sir.
So I want to ask you one question. Have you seen an average speaker? Average. Okay. Not very great, not very bad. Have you seen an average speaker in your life?
Yeah.
Have you seen a bad speaker? Failing someone going on the stage, not able to speak, returning back from the stage without saying a word. We all see in the life, right?
Yeah.
The more you will see, more fear will increase. If you see someone failing on the stage, you think, my God, what is this happening? Okay. And have you seen any great speaker?
Yeah.
Can you tell me some name? Can you tell me some name?
Aaron Lawrence.
Mm-hmm.
In the Institute of Brain Therapy.
Mm-hmm.
And some of Napoleon Hill and Dale Carnegie Institute, I saw a lot of speakers from their institute.
Super.
While training sessions.
Great, great. Chetu Singhi, do you know any great speaker?
Not really. We just listen to the docs.
Oh, you don't know any great speaker?
As such, not really. Because generally, we listen to the doctors and all. I'm not into that kind of like of general knowledge and kind of things.
No. So have you heard the name of Tony Robbins? No.
Sorry, not at all.
Okay. No problem. Don't worry. You are going to learn. So I can understand, but you are in a profession where you have to speak. Mrs. Parmeshwari, have you heard the name of, do you know anyone who is a great speaker? You can unmute yourself. Yeah.
Rajesh Tagore, Kazim Raza, so many speakers I have seen, sir. Leader Factory and...
Okay. So what are the qualities of these speakers? Now you have to tell the qualities. Okay. Now you told me that you know the speakers. Now you have to tell me the qualities of this speaker.
I've heard of Sandeep Maheshwari.
Sandeep Maheshwari, he's a great speaker.
Yes, he's a great speaker.
He's a great speaker.
The jolliness and the communication he does with the people. Mm-hmm. He makes so comfortable the scenario is by mm-hmm. talking even the silliest or the serious point he's talking mm-hmm. on. He mm-hmm. make it so light. The atmosphere is very light. Even you can attend it for 3 hours, 4 hours. But the atmosphere is very light and generally he depicts the examples which mm-hmm. generally I think the speaker lag behind.
Mm-hmm. So can you tell me one by one qualities in one word? Okay. All of you. What are the qualities of great speaker? Number one, I'm writing. I have already shared my screen with you. I think you can see my screen now. Are you able to see my screen?
No, I am not able to see your screen.
It's blank, sir. It's blank.
It's blank.
Yeah, it's blank.
Yeah.
So I have to write here.
Okay.
Whatever you say. What are the qualities of great speaker? You tell me.
Continuous learning is the first quality for a trainer, speaker.
But learning, we will not learn here. What are the qualities?
Correct.
When you see a speaker, when you see, you know, he is speaking and you say, wow, that time what you are noticing?
The interaction.
The body language is main for speakers, sir.
Body language, yeah.
And the voice tone.
Voice tone of the voice. Because you are a trainer, that's why you are saying this. Anything else?
Interaction with the people.
Ah, that is very important. Interaction. That is very important.
Subject knowledge and confidence.
Subject knowledge, yes.
The topic knowledge is very important, what they are talking.
Yeah, topic should be, they should walk the talk. It is not that if someone is asking question, he is saying like, I will answer your question later. If someone asks, whatever you ask, I have to give the answer. That's it.
Yeah.
He should be walking the talk, whatever he is talking. Yeah?
Yeah, correct.
So four we have mentioned. Are you able to see what I am typing?
No, sir.
No.
Let me check. One more time.
Sir, can you give the option for recording, sir?
I'm already recording it. I will give you recording video.
Oh, okay. Fine. Okay.
It is live. I think you didn't hear in that webinar. I told that.
I remember.
You can repeat the program. Because you don't need to repeat it. Because you will learn, remember everything here only. That's why it is a live interactive class. Okay. You don't need to repeat, but if you want to, you can repeat. Because sometimes happens, you go in a different zone altogether. Life, you know, sometimes knocked off and you are in different zone. So maybe
sometimes we want to clarify the doubt. So I am asking that.
Yes. And you have lifetime access for, you know, every month meetup. There also you can clarify your doubt.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So anything else? Subject knowledge, interaction, voice, body language. Now I think you can see my screen.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So now tell me, what is the next quality?
Eye contact is very important for the speaker.
Eye contact. Anything else missing? So without further delay, you will learn all of this, and anything you think, you know, I will teach all of you this, and anything which you think is missing, you can tell me that also, I will teach you. It is not about teaching, it's about learning. Yeah.
Learning. Okay.
So I will, you know, you will learn all this as well as whatever, you know, we are going to. Maybe you bring one idea that, no, we should focus on this also. Then we can go on to that topic also. Yes.
Okay.
So basically, you know, mind is like a monkey. All the time it is busy showing, you know, something negative here and there, jumping. Okay. So, you know, what you know me as a great speaker, but I was also struggling. Okay. Everyone struggle public speaking. It is, you know, 90% people fear public speaking. Okay. So basically, you know, in next 6 days, I will make sure, you know, every one of you has a speaker within you, sleeping speaker. Okay. Everyone, not only speaker, every one of you has a warrior. Every one of you has an entrepreneur. Okay. Everyone has you, you know, you have many parts of mind. If you read psychology, there are layers by layer. It is not only two mind, conscious and subconscious. No, there are multi levels of mind and each mind is responsible for many things. You have warrior within you. You have entrepreneur within you. Okay. So my job here is to wake up, you know, the speaker within you within 6 days. And I will make sure this speaker wakes up and roars. Okay. Not only learns, but roars and goes and talks in front of thousands and thousands of people without any nervousness and without any doubt. Yeah. So that's my goal is. All I need is your participation. You know, whenever you are requested to speak, you are supposed to speak, you know, without any hesitation. Because you are here to learn, you have to be ready to fail. If you fail here, then only you will succeed there. Okay, if you don't fail here, then you will fail there. Yes, you have to fail here in order to succeed there. And I'll make sure, you know, it is going to blow your mind. You are going to learn a lot of things. Yes. So are we ready?
Yeah.
So now your mind will be thinking, you know, now Kaushal will wake up this, you know, sleeping speaker, what pills and injection he will bring, you know. So, you know, I will give you the pills and injections now. Ready for it?
Yeah, ready.
You will be thinking, sleeping speaker within me, how it will wake up. There will be some injection, there will be some pills. Yeah. So let's begin, jump in. 1 minute, please. I want to share my screen with you. All of you can see my screen?
Yeah. Root cause.
Yes.
Yes.
So why you are not a great speaker is because there is a root cause. And root cause, what is the root cause according to you? Why we are not a, you know, you are not a very successful, you know, mind-blowing speaker. What is the root cause according to you? So we will, you know, going to cover this in three things. Only three things you need to learn and master and you will be boom. Okay. So you need to master root cause. You not need to master structure and then delivery and that's it. Yes. So what is the root cause according to you of you being not being the great speaker which you want to be? Or maybe you are, okay, but still want to grow. Maybe you are a good speaker, but still you want to take yourself to the next level. What is stopping you? What is that one word which is stopping you?
Fear.
Fear? Anything fear else? Anything else?
Consciousness.
Sorry?
Consciousness.
Consciousness. You are conscious. Anything else?
We are not accepting the failure.
You are not accepting the failure. Okay?
Failure.
See, all these things are there. There, if you go like that, there will be many things. But the major thing what you have is you have nervousness. Yes?
Yes.
Anyone, yes. Anyone in the world, you fear public speaking because of nervousness. Yes?
Yes.
This word is nervousness. And this is this monster which keeps 90% people of the world, you know, to stay in the comfort zone. Okay. So how to overcome nervousness? How to overcome nervousness? How to overcome nervousness? Yeah. That's we are going to master. So the number one thing when it comes to nervousness is, okay, what it is according to you?
Whatever we know, let me forget when we go to the stage.
That is the doubt what you have, that you will forget, right? But you have nervousness. But you have nervousness in your
sometimes
head.
Sometimes.
But sometimes you'll go sit there. Okay. So nervousness is the main thing. Okay. How to overcome nervousness? So you are going to learn many of the techniques. Okay.
By the topic, I think it goes.
Sorry.
By knowing the topic deeply, the nervousness will go.
No. It will be there. It will be there even if you know the topic. Okay.
I think by boosting yourself, like giving you the positive vibes, yes, you can rock it and you can do it like that. Generally, it comes, we know the topic, we know everything, but we get a little nervous regarding how we're going to implement it or not. But yes. Sometimes it happens on same, like two lectures are there. One day it is all fine. Another day it's not fine. But it is only the point is we are like not making it like affirmative ourselves. We are going to deliver very nicely. So that positive vibes, I think that is missing might be.
Yes. So all Mrs. Chetusingi said is correct. Okay. But the number one problem what we have is, okay, is taking public speaking as threat. Number one. What is the number one? Taking public speaking as threat. The moment public speaking comes in mind, it may be you or somebody else. The first thing is threat. I don't want to do it. Okay. It's not that you are saying, maybe you are getting ready. You know, you want to speak, but your mind is saying that no, I don't want to do this at any cost. Maybe you force yourself, you know, to do that, but your mind is saying, no, 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 I don't want to do this. Yes. So first word is take public speaking as opportunity. Say with me that public speaking is an opportunity. You have to repeat now.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
You have to repeat 10 times. Public speaking is an opportunity.
Opportunity.
And involve your body. Involve your body because you are complete, you know, this cell will remember, you will not forget. Public speaking is an opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity. Public speaking is an opportunity. Public speaking is an opportunity. Public speaking is an opportunity. Public speaking is an
opportunity. Public speaking is an opportunity.
Super, super. I think all of you are repeating with me because you have to repeat this involving your body. Otherwise, this will not work. If you don't repeat.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Opportunity, yes. Repeat as many times you can.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Public
speaking is an opportunity.
Also
public speaking is an opportunity.
Yes. Yes. So public speaking, taking public speaking is an opportunity. So what will happen from today onwards, okay, with you, whenever public speaking opportunity will come, now your mind will automatically think, no, it's an opportunity. Yes. And you will jump in. Why it is opportunity is, the moment you think it is an opportunity, 25% fear is, nervousness is gone. 25% nervousness is gone. You don't have nervousness the moment you think that it's an opportunity. Because mind is like, you know, it's a machine. It's like a computer. So what you are doing by, you know, saying this is, you are hacking your mind. You will not believe. After the day I completed this course, some 8 years back, okay, whenever public speaking will come, someone will say that you have to go for a meeting, or you have to go for a speaking, I will be the first excited person, you know, that wow, it's an opportunity to prove myself that I am a leader, because I don't have any fear. And if little bit is there, you know, sometimes here and there, I don't care, because it's an opportunity to grow. You will not believe, I have worked for 12 years for different corporate. The moment they will announce meeting in the corporate, I work for Tata, HCL and many other companies. So I have gone for meeting with the, you know, 500 people also. On daily basis, they will do 2 to 3 time meetings. Maybe you have worked for corporate or not, I don't know. Okay, because most of all of you are, you know, business owners and you are into business, not in a job. So I have worked in a job. The moment they will announce there is a meeting, everyone's face will go till here. Okay. Everyone wants to avoid the meeting. No one wants to go for meeting because there they have to speak. People may ask his boss will ask the question and he have to speak. And everyone is fearful to speak in front of 20, 30, 10, 15 members. But just this word, that this is an opportunity, changes this completely. Yes. So again, let's say one more time, you know, public speaking is an opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Speaking is an opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
I am a great speaker.
I am a great speaker.
Yes, that's it. So this is number one. Number two. Number two is negative self-talk. So now you have taken the opportunity. Okay. The number two problem why you have nervousness or fear is negative self-talk. Because mind is a monkey. Okay, maybe you are, you know, you have never seen your mind. So you don't know it. But, you know, for the people who have done little bit meditation and tried to see his mind, they know that mind is always talking. Always. All the time. Whether you know it or not know it.
Yes.
So if you are a very, you know, powerful mind, then you might have 60,000 thoughts. 60,000 times it is talking in a single day. And if you have little bit, you know, you are thinking a lot, then suppose you are, you know, you are not feeling well today, then that day you will be thinking 70,000 thoughts. And 90% of that is negative. 90% of that is negative. All the time talking negative. And particularly when it comes to public speaking, okay, The moment someone tell you. The moment someone tell you that, boss, you have to go for a meeting or you have to go and speak on the stage. Now, first thing it will say that, no. I don't want it. The second thing is negative self-talk. You are going to fail. People are going to laugh. People are going to throw chappal. People are going to throw sandals. My God, you are getting humiliated. People are laughing at you. Okay. And you don't know this. You don't know because you are not in the habit of listening to your mind. You are thinking, what the hell is happening? Why I am fearful? I am such a strong guy or girl or woman. Why suddenly I am feeling fear? Because you don't know what the hell is happening. Your mind is now talking. You will fail. And you have no idea why you have this fear. You are a successful person. You are a business owner. You have this, you have that. And still you have fear. Why? Because your mind is all the time talking negative. So now what you have to do? You have to replace this negative with positive. Yes?
Yes.
Yes.
So what, yes. Simply you have to, you know, number one thing is, public speaking is an opportunity. Number two is, I am a great speaker. So repeat with me.
I am a great speaker.
Now the second line. Okay.
I am the greatest person.
Greatest person.
Ever born.
On this earth.
I am. The best speaker.
The best speaker.
Ever born.
On this earth.
I am the greatest person.
Ever born.
On this earth. Okay. So now we have learned two techniques. Yes. Two techniques we have learned. Number one is taking public speaking as opportunity. So now, whenever someone says that you have to go for meeting or you have to go on the stage, now your mind is saying, what? Wow, let's do it. Yes. Simply, it's an opportunity for you to prove. No matter what, it's an opportunity for me. That's the first thing you know. The second thing you know is, to positive self-talk. You don't have to think, no. Just start telling 3 to 4 times. I'm going to rock the stage. Okay. So repeat with me once more time. You know,
I'm going to rock the stage.
See, you have to, Chetu, you have to involve your body because you're, you know, this is called incantation. This is not affirmation, which never work. This is incantation, yeah. Which you involve your body. The whole, you know, every cell will remember. Otherwise, you will forget.
I'm going to rock with people. That's why I'm just not.
No, Chaitanya, I'm not telling to you because I can see that you are driving. I'm telling to Chetu, Mr. Chetu Singhi. And Mr. Suresh and Parmeshwari is enjoying all the time. They are already doing it. Okay. So I am a great speaker.
I am a great speaker.
I believe in myself. So we can do it easily, right? These two things. Number one, taking public speaking opportunity. Number two is positive self-talk. Number three, what is the number three according to you? I will not go according to you again. It will become, you know, a lot of late. So let me tell you straight away. So number three is you are in head. You are in where? You are in your head. Everyone, most of the people, most of the time, they are in their head. And if you are in your head, you are dead. It is like dead. Because you are not connected with anyone. What is not connected? The thing which is in head is not connected with not anyone. Connected. Yeah. And if you are not connected, then you are dead. It is like dead. Right? So what you have to do is, what being in the head simply means that you are thinking something. Okay? You are not present. And particularly when you are speaking with someone, you should be connected. You should be focused, you know, to, you know, what they are feeling, you know. Maybe you are feeling bored and as a speaker, I'm not able to focus. I'm listening to my head. Then do you think that I can continue? No, I don't have to be in the head. I have to be present. What being in present means that you have to move from here to here, from here to here. Okay. So you have to, you know, feel the things, all the things. You have to feel the air. You have to feel the temperature. Okay. Everything. You are like, you know, you have to feel your complete body, not only in head where you are listening what is positive or negative is going on. No, you have to be present. Okay. So not being in the head simply means that you are present with the whole of the being and you are completely focused on other people. Okay. To whom you are talking to. You can see the reactions. Okay. You can see the, you know, the way they speak, you know, when you ask the question, what they are replying, you are thinking that you are not in your head. Okay. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
So repeat with me. Being in the head is dead.
Being in the head is dead.
Being in the head is dead.
Yeah. Being in the head is dead.
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 So now we have done three. All three you remember? So you can go and shout all three one by one. I will just listen.
Public speaking is an opportunity. Public speaking is an opportunity.
No.
I am a speaker. I am a speaker.
Great speaker. Great speaker.
Great speaker.
I believe in myself. Positive self-talk is not only one word. It should be 3 to 4. I am a great speaker. I believe in myself. I am going to rock the stage. Okay. Now number three. What is number three?
Being in the head is dead.
So no one will speak now. I will start with Mrs. Parmeshwari. Mrs. Parmeshwari.
Is dead.
Sir, tell me the third one.
Sorry?
Tell me the third one sentence.
Being in the head is dead. Don't worry, Mr. Suresh. You will get the template towards the end of this. You know?
Okay, no problem. Being the head is dead.
Being in the head is dead.
Is dead. Yes? Okay.
So now, Mrs. Parmeshwari, you have to tell all three one by one. First, second, third.
Public speaking is a great opportunity for me. Public speaking is a great opportunity for me. Public speaking is a great opportunity for me. Okay. I am a great public speaker. I am a great public speaker. I am a great public speaker. I am rocking the stage. I am rocking the stage. I am rocking the stage. I am rocking the stage.
Number three.
Being head is on the dead. 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 Being head is on the dead.
Superb, superb, superb. That's the energy. So you will become a great speaker right now, I can tell you. So Mr. Suresh, you are already a speaker. Now you have to repeat.
No, sir. I am not a speaker.
No. First, second, third. You have to repeat. There is no escape here. You have to speak first, second, third. Not like Mrs. Parmeshwari. She is like awesome, mind-blowing. First, second, third. Three lines you have to tell.
I want to repeat?
Yes.
Yeah. I am a great speaker. I am a great speaker. I am a great speaker.
No. Public speaking is an opportunity.
First line.
Yes. First, second, third.
Public speaking is an opportunity. Public speaking is an opportunity.
No. You don't have to do this. You have to tell first one, then second, and then third one. Only one line, two lines, third line.
Okay. Public speaking is an opportunity. I am a great speaker. Being in the head is dead.
Super awesome. Mrs. Chetu Singhi, now your turn.
Public speaking is an opportunity. I'm the best speaker in the world. I can do it. And being in the head is dead.
One more time. All three. Yeah.
Public speaking is an opportunity. I'm the best speaker in the world and I'll do it. And being in the head is dead.
Mr. Chaitanya, now you have to repeat. All three, one by one.
Public speaking is an opportunity. I am a great speaker. Public speaking is an opportunity. I am a great speaker. Second one is...
Being in the head is dead.
Third one, sir. Being in the head is dead.
Head is dead.
Super awesome. So now I can see that, you know, ladies are, you know, overtaking on male here. So they are completely, you know, energetic.
Okay? We are give the way, sir.
Yes, 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 yes. No, you are not giving the way. They are making their way own way.
Making their own path.
Yes. Awesome. So let's jump into the next one. Now, next one is very, very important. Okay. Go with a service attitude. Which attitude? Service attitude. Okay. See, you are going to speak there, okay, not to, you know, take something, okay? You are going to give service. Now, take example of postman, okay? Now, think that postman is going to deliver a letter and he is going, okay? And the moment he reach on the door, he starts thinking, who will open the door, okay? What will happen? Who is inside? Maybe some, you know, very big pahalwan. Or, you know, very bad person, you know, or maybe, you know, who is will open. And then he thinks, what is written in this letter? What is not written? Starts thinking, suppose, what will happen? He will be able to deliver the letter? No. He will, after 3 to 4 days, he will run away. He will leave that job. So his job is to go and deliver the letter and come back. Yes?
Yes.
In the same way, your job is to, when you are going to speak, you are going to give. You are not going to take something, right? So you don't have to go there with an attitude to take something. You don't have any fear because you are going to give. Yes? You are going to deliver with a service attitude. Take one more example. Mr. Chaitanya, are you married or unmarried?
I am married, sir.
You are married. Okay, so no one is unmarried here. So we will take one example. Suppose somebody is unmarried, okay? And he loves one girl. Take one example. There is a guy who is unmarried and he loves one girl. Now he is going to propose, okay? So in one hand, he is having one letter, okay, to propose. In second hand, he is having one biryani packet, okay? Two, because he loves biryani, okay? Because he loves biryani, so he wanted to propose. Now he has taken the chicken biryani and he has taken one letter and he is going to propose. Now on the way, he saw that there is one lady around 25 years of age, okay? And she is sitting on a roadside because, you know, something happened with his husband, some fight or something. And she is sitting with the children, okay, there. Now they are hungry, so he give the biryani packet to that lady. Okay, that lady is also, you know, beautiful. That girl is also beautiful, and that girl is also. Now he goes and give the letter to the girl. Now when he will be feeling the fear, what time? While giving the biryani packet to lady, or while giving that letter to the lady? He will have no fear when he gives the biryani. Yes.
Yes.
Because he is going with a service attitude. He is not going to take anything. But when he is going to, you know, give letter, now his mind is thinking whether it will be no or yes, because he has expectation. Expectation is he is having, right? So simply what, you know, going with, you know, with a service attitude means is, you know, you don't have any expectation. Okay. Your mind is not thinking, you know, what I will get, what I will not get and all that. Yes. Now the next thing, you know, so can we repeat again one by one, all these four, because we have to make it automatic in our system. Yeah. So what is the number one?
public speaking is an opportunity.
What is number two? Everyone, please repeat.
I am the best speaker.
I'm the great speaker. I'm going to rock the stage. I'm a powerful person. Number three.
Being in the head is dead.
Number four.
Go with the service attitude.
I will go with the service attitude. I don't have any expectation. No expectation. So all four we are done. Yes. Yeah. Number five. Speak from the heart. Okay. What does it mean?
Speak from the heart.
Yeah. What it means is, now you speak only the thing which you have knowledge of, which you have experience of. See, if you are going to speak something which you have read somewhere, okay, or you have just listened somewhere, you are going to have 1,000 times fear than if you just go and speak your life experience. After reaching till 5, now you will have no fear. Only fear will come now, after learning this 4, if you have, if you think you don't know the subject and you are somewhere, you are reading or you have learned and you think, now, maybe you have read somewhere some mind power tools. Now you think, wow, how great it is. I can teach it to other people and you have no knowledge, right? So if you are going to speak something which you have no knowledge, then you will feel fear. Speaking from heart simply means that you speak something which is you have experience. Okay. Say like your own story. Okay. Your own story. Now you are telling your own story. Now you will have no fear. Every one of us have many stories. Okay. Yes. Stories are like when you go on a travel. Okay. When you went on a holiday, that is a story. When you went for a, in a marriage of your cousin, brother or sister, that is a story. Now you got it? What is story?
Yeah.
You went for your cousin, brother, sister. Now you had some experience there. That is a story. You went on a vacation somewhere. Okay. Anywhere. Any hill station. Kullu, Manali, Umti, Mr. Suresh. Okay. Then that is your story. You can tell. You reached there. How you felt. How was the atmosphere. How you are feeling. All that you can tell. So when you tell that and you show that, what it is, then you have no fear. Yeah. So what is this thing? Next one.
Simply our experiences story.
Yes. Speak from the heart. Yeah. Yes. You have to go and speak from your heart. So can we repeat one more time all that?
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Okay.
I am a great speaker.
Okay.
I am working.
Sorry?
Being in the head is dead.
Yes. Everyone, please,
go
everyone.
With the same attitude without servicing attitude.
Okay. Okay.
Speak from heart.
Speak from the heart.
Speak from your heart. Okay.
Heart.
Okay, super awesome. You are doing a great job. I can see that. You have to, here today itself, you have to remember this. Please remember. If you don't remember this, then case is gone. Okay. Again, you will stuck somewhere. All this you have to make here. Okay, go in. And coming next 6 days, we will again repeat. So that for lifetime, you don't need to remember. I have to go with service attitude. Now it is automatic in your system. You are going, you are not remembering. Automatically everything will happen. Okay. After the 6 days, whenever you will go on the stage, you don't need to do all this thing, anything. Now you will be thinking, 10th thing I have to remember. No. It will come automatically. You have learned only your mind is a monkey, but I have not told you that your mind is very, very strong. It can bring any result. That actually the result which is getting now, it is because of it only. Result what we are getting is because of this. And whatever result we want, it can bring it. Only we have to give training. That's it. So suppose monkey is there. Now you want monkey to walk on the rope. What you will do? Give training, you will walk on the rope.
You have to give training.
Yeah, you want monkey to dance. Now what do you have to do? Give training, simply. So this is your training. You are training. Once training is done, now lifetime you don't need to worry. Okay, automatically it will keep on doing its job. Yes? And one more thing, whenever you learn new thing, your brain becomes stronger and stronger and more powerful. Because brain is a very huge capacity to connect with multiple neurons and make itself very, very strong. So whenever you are learning in real time, your psychological brain and physical brain is changing right now. So you should know this, okay? What is going on with you? Right now, your physical brain and psychological brain is literally changing. If you have a scanner right now, if you put, you can see it. Right now, it will be connecting with multiple neurons because you are learning a very powerful skill. Yes? And you are making it remember. So where we are, go with a service attitude or speak from the heart. Now the next thing is, who thinks what? Now next thing will come is, why the hell he is laughing? Now you are on the stage and someone is laughing, someone is smiling, okay? Or someone is talking to each other. Now your mind thinks, why the hell he is laughing? Right? Am I bad? Is he laughing on me? Am I not speaking good? Yes? Your mind will start thinking out like that. Yes? It happens? It happens? When you are on the stage and yes. You know, people are talking to each other and they are smiling. Now your mind is thinking like, who is thinking what? Yes?
Yes. Yes?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
So, for, you know, to remove that, you know, simply, I will tell you one story. There was an old person, once upon a time, there was an old person living in a village, okay? In a remote village, there was no road, nothing. Only fields, agriculture land, yes? And that person, you know, had only one son, okay? And that guy, all the family member had was dead in his family, okay? He has only donkey. Now he has no agriculture land also. Now this guy had only one donkey. So he thought, why not sell this donkey and get some money? So where he will sell, he has to go to town, city. Yeah. So both of the father and son decided to, you know, go to the city and sell this donkey and get some money so that they can survive. Yes. So they started traveling. So now father said that, son, we have to go a long way. City is very far from this remote village. Why don't you sit on the donkey, okay? Because we cannot walk in such a scorching sun, you can sit on the donkey. Now, son sat on the donkey and they started moving towards city. While moving across, they came across a village, okay? Now, all the villagers are shouting, what kind of son you are? Your father, old father is walking and you are sitting on the donkey, enjoying the life, right? Now, these guys are thinking, you know, the son got down, now father sat on the donkey. Now, son is walking. While walking, they reached another village. Now, again, people are shouting, what kind of father you are? Your young son is walking and you are sitting on donkey? Shame on you. Now, again, they are surprised, what to do? Again, he got down. Okay? Now, what he did is, everyone is saying like, you know, now both of them sat on that. Okay. Now they are walking. They reached one village. Again, people are saying, hey, shameless people, this donkey will die. Can't you see? All two people are sitting in a single donkey. It will die. So both of them say, no, what the people are saying. So both of them went down, bring one stick, bamboo stick, and make the, you know, this donkey hang on, no, upside down. On that bamboo, and they put like this, and they are going now. Now, while they reach the city, this donkey is dead because the blood went into the brain. The donkey is like hanging like this, and they are taking this. No, because people are saying, you know, and now people are clapping. The next village people, wow, we have never seen something like this. It's a beautiful. This is a wonderful thing. I have never seen something like this. So simply know that, you know, simply just know that no matter how bad speaker you are, okay, there will be somebody who will like it, who will love it. Okay. No matter how great speaker you are, okay, there will be people who will dislike you. who will dislike you. For example, take me. 10 years back, I used to hate Tony Robbins. I used to hate Tony Robbins 10 years back, but now I love him. 10 years back, whenever I will hear his voice, I will think like, what kind of voice it is? Very, you know, very heavy voice. He has a very heavy voice. Okay. But that doesn't matter, Tony Robbins, his number one speaker. I hated him that time because of his, you know, I liked only soft voice that time. But it doesn't matter. He is number one trainer, whether I like him, 10% people like him or don't like him. What is the difference? No difference. 10 years back, he was number one. Today also is number one. That time I didn't like him. Today I like him. But that doesn't matter. Yes. So after you know that you are speaking from heart, you are going with a service attitude, you have no fear. Public speaking is an opportunity for you. Yeah. You are not in your head. Now, you don't have to worry who thinks what. Yes. You are not in your head now. You are a great speaker. You are going to speak on the stage and you are going to wow the audience. Yes. So simple word is, I'm going to, if somebody, no matter what it is, someone will like you, like me, and someone will dislike me.
Dislike.
Yeah. So simple word is, who damn cares? What's the word?
Who damn cares?
Who damn cares? Yes.
Who damn cares?
Now repeat with me. Who damn cares?
Who damn cares?
Yes. Now we will repeat again from the beginning. Yes. Can we do it all together?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. So let's start. Public speaking, everyone. Opportunity.
Public speaking is the opportunity.
I go with a service attitude.
I speak from heart. Who damn cares?
Now the next one. Speak to express, not to impress. Yes. Speak to express.
Can't audio.
Speak to express, not to impress. What happens when you go to, you know, impress, you know, your mind is, you know, looking for approval. Same thing. Who, you know, who is thinking what? It is the same thing. Yes. Who is thinking what? So you are going to express there. You are not going to impress somebody. Yes. Your mind should be, so I'm going to express. Yeah. Not to impress. So you have to always remember this also. I'm going to express, not to impress. I'm going to express, not to impress. I'm going to express, not to impress. So you don't care. Number one thing you said, who damn care? Okay. Now,
okay. That's the best part, sir.
Yeah. Who damn cares? Yeah. Hey, not only you have to say who damn care, you have to also tell why who damn cares. Because some people will like me. Always, no matter how bad you are. See, you if you simply say who damn cares, right now you will feel okay. But later your mind will think, you know, why I should not care? I should care. Okay. Your mind is very smart. You will, right now it is feeling, wow, 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 who damn cares? But later it will come and ask you, okay, why I should not care? Huh? They are doing so many troubles. Why should I not care? I will care. So you have to simply tell that boss, you should not care, because no matter how good you are, people will dislike you. How bad you are, there will be people who will like you. That's why you should not care. You should not go in hotspot who is thinking what and who is doing what. Yeah. So simply go to express, not to impress. I don't want to impress anybody. Simple. Yes. I'm going with a service attitude. I'm not here to impress you. Yeah.
I'm going service attitude, not to impress you.
Yeah. Because the moment I'm going to impress you, I'm going to fail. That's why I don't want to impress anyone. Simply. The moment you have expectation, okay, now you will seek approval. The moment, you know, you will start looking for approvals from the people. You will start looking at people's faces, what they are saying and what they are thinking and what they are doing. Yes? Done?
Yes. Yes.
So the next thing is, no matter what you are, who you are, okay, still you will have little bit nervousness. Still you will have little bit nervousness. Why? Because we have nerve in the body. What is nervousness? It is related to nerve. Yes? Nervousness, simply word, comes from nerve. So you have nerve. So there will be nervousness, little bit. That's okay to be nervous. Yeah? It's okay to be nervous. Yeah? But still you can kill it, whatever is remaining. How? How? Even if small amount of nervousness is there, you can kill it. Because you have nerve, still you feel might be, because you want 100% nervousness free. Yes? Replace the word nervousness with excitement. What's the word?
Excitement.
Say, I'm excited to speak.
Excited.
I'm excited to speak.
Excited to speak.
I'm excited. Involve your body. I'm excited to speak.
I'm excited to
speak.
I'm excited to speak on the stage.
I'm excited to speak on the stage.
Yes.
I am now, excited on the stage.
Now what happens? No. When you are excited and when you are nervous, the body chemical reaction is the same. Okay. But your mind reaction is different. Okay. So suppose you are a cricket lover or football lover. Okay. On the, you know, suppose if it is cricket, on last ball, your country needs 6 runs to win and it is World Cup final. Now, what will be your condition? Maybe you are a football lover. Now, only 1 minute remaining and both the teams are equal and your team need one goal to win the game. Now, what will be the condition? Take for example, suppose you are waiting for your turn to go and speak on the stage. Okay. Now your turn is coming slowly. Now you have 5 minute time, you are waiting. What happens? You have a little bit sweat here, most of the people. Heartbeat goes up. The more nervousness you have, the bigger will be heartbeat. Now if you are new, then it will be like boom, 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 boom. You are feeling nervous. And you have a little bit sweat and your hands and legs are little shaky. Not like this, little bit. It will be little bit. Okay? So that is nervousness. The more you have, more nervousness. And what happens when you are excited, when you are waiting for the last ball, the 6 runs, same thing. You have sweat. Your heartbeat is up. You are feeling a little shaky. So it is science proven. It is not just theory. Science has scanned the body in both the cases and has proven that the chemical reaction is the same when you are excited and when you are nervous. Okay. But mind reaction is different. When you say I'm nervous, your mind will say, oh my God, I don't want to do this. Okay. But when you say that I'm excited, now your mind says, wow, let's have fun, enjoy. Okay. So you have to replace the word nervousness with excitement. So if you are feeling little sweat and your heartbeat going up, you are feeling little shaky, someone comes from there, your friend, and asks you, are you feeling nervous? Say, no. I am feeling excited. Yes?
Right.
You have to tell yourself in your mind, I am feeling excited, excited, excited. I am feeling excited to speak. Now one or two times, you know, if you do it, yeah. I am excited to speak on the stage. Yes? Now you have completely
excited.
Yeah. You have hacked your mind and your mind is thinking like, wow, I am excited. Let's have fun. Let's go on the stage and let's rock it, man. I am excited. Just by, because this brain, I told you, right? Yes. It is very powerful, but it is a computer. It is a damn computer. You can hack it very easily. The moment you tell some other story, it will say, oh, okay. It is like damn computer. So what you are doing, you are hacking it. You are just telling it. And sometimes when you practice for 6 days, these things, what will happen is, now it is automatic. Now you don't have to do this. Okay. Every time you go, you will just, you know, you just have to take that opportunity and everything will happen automatically. Only one thing you have to remember, I have to take it as opportunity. All these things will come automatically. You have to right now repeat again and again. Yes? Yes?
Yes.
So can we repeat
public
one
speaking
more?
Is an opportunity.
Yes, public speaking is an opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
I'm the best. I'm the best speaker in the world.
I am a great speaker.
No. Please, listen. We have to repeat 3 times. One single, we have to repeat 3 times and then we'll go to second one. Only 3 times. The first line should be 3 times, then second line 3 times, third 3 times. Okay? Yes, like that we'll go. So,
okay.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Wait. The best way is I will tell and you tell behind me. Okay. Yes, and then we will do. Then we'll do one by one. Yes, is it fine? So public speaking is an opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Being in head is dead.
Being in head is dead.
I am a great speaker. I go with service attitude.
I go with service attitude.
I speak from the heart.
I speak to express, not to impress.
Who damn cares?
Okay. I'm excited to speak on the stage. Now the final. We have placed. Reached at the final place. Okay. The final technique of the day for the nervousness. It's okay to be nervous. Don't show it to them. What is the technique? It's okay to be nervous. Don't show it to them.
But don't show it to them.
Yes. How you show it? So I'm here. Please, everyone, don't look at, you know, my beard. I am not able to shave today. Now, what will happen? Everyone will look it. Most of the speaker make this mistake. The moment they will go on the stage, the first thing they will, you know, tell that because they are fearful. Now, to protect them, they will say either, I am not well prepared. I didn't get the time. Okay. I was not able to sleep like last night. Now what he's thinking is, he's thinking like, when I will tell, people will support me. Okay. that bechara, he is not able to sleep. Okay, but what happens now if I tell you, you know, don't, you know, see my beard, I was not able to save. Now your mind will always go there only, all the time. Why is not able to save? Why? He is a speaker, he is coming for such a training and he is not able to save his beard. All the time your mind is focused. So if you say that, you know, I'm not able to sleep. Now audience mind is always searching for problem. If he is not able to sleep, what mistake he can make? Not only that, your mind is also now focused on that. Because I'm not able to sleep, what all mistake I will make? So never share. What is the word? Never share.
Never share.
Never okay? Share.
The main point is don't, you know, it's okay to be nervous. Don't show it to them. Don't show it to them. It's okay to be nervous. Don't show it to them. How you show them? You say them, show them by telling directly. Yeah? You tell them directly that, boss, I'm not able to sleep. I'm not well prepared or something. Now, people mind is focusing more on that. The number two is, you show it with your body language. Yeah? You are moving here and there like a tiger. Okay? On the stage. Or you are feeling a little shaky. Or you show it with your eye connection. You are looking here and there and this. No, you have to keep focus on people. Yes? So, don't tell directly and don't show it with your body language. Yes? It's okay to be nervous. Don't show it to them. Okay? What is the word? It's okay to be nervous.
It's okay to be nervous. Don't show it to them.
Yes.
Don't show it them.
How you show it? Telling directly. Body language, voice, telling and eye connection.
Body language.
Yeah. Body language.
And eye connection.
Voice, eye connection.
Body language, yeah. Eye connection.
Telling directly, body language, voice, eye connection. Yes.
Telling directly, body language, eye connection.
Voice also, voice. Your voice will be, you know, if you are not, you know, fully confident, your voice will be, you know, little shallow. Okay? Little fearful. Yeah? But when you are fully confident, you will speak from, you know, you will be open to speak. Right? Right?
Yeah, yes. Right, sir.
So right. This is what the techniques are. Now, can we repeat one more time?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. So,
yes.
Yes.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
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 Opportunity.
Public speaking is an opportunity.
Being in head is dead.
Being in head is dead.
Being in head is dead. Being in head is dead.
Being in head is dead.
I am a great speaker.
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 I go with the service attitude. I go with the service attitude. I speak to express, not to impress.
I speak to express, not to impress.
I speak to express, speak not to impress.
I speak to express, not to impress.
I speak from the heart.
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 Who damn cares?
Who damn cares?
Who damn cares?
Who damn cares?
Who damn cares? Okay?
Who damn cares?
Who damn cares?
I'm excited to speak. I'm excited to speak on the stage.
I am excited to speak
on the stage. I'm excited to speak on the stage. I'm excited to speak on the stage.
I'm excited to speak on the stage.
It's okay.
I'm excited to speak on the stage.
It's okay to be nervous. Don't show to them.
Okay, it's okay to be nervous. Don't show it to them.
Don't show it to them.
It's okay to be nervous.
Don't show it to them. Yes?
Them.
Now we are done.
It is okay to them. It is okay to be nervous, but show it to them.
Sure, awesome. Now what you have to do is, now what you think when you go on the stage, what is the degree of fear you feel? It should be 1% to 100%. Okay? What is the percentage of fear you feel? Not now, not after this course, before that. What is the percentage of fear you used to feel? You have to write behind a notepad or somewhere and keep it with you. Okay? Yes?
Yes.
Write the percentage of nervousness, and after 5 minutes you have to show me whatever you have written. Okay?
I didn't get you.
You have to write on a piece of paper what is the level of fear you feel or nervousness when you go and speak on the stage before this class. Okay? Before this class, what was the percentage of nervousness from 1 to 100? 100 being the maximum. 1 being that there is no fear, no nervousness. What is the fear you felt you have percentage? Not now, before that, before this class. This is another technique. Okay? You have to write on a piece of paper and you have to show me after 5 minutes. Okay? Now you guys are going to introduce yourself. Okay? You guys are going to introduce yourself, or you have to tell one experience. You can tell one of the experience which you had in your life. Maybe you went on a vacation, you went for a marriage. Okay? You have to tell that story. You have, everyone will be given 2 minutes time. How much? 2 minutes time to tell a story of your, from your past. It can be any story. Okay? And you have to implement all of what you have learned. Okay? You have to do some positive self-talk. Okay? First of all, only if you do two things, then everything will be taken care. Take it as an opportunity. Right now, I know that everyone's mind is thinking, no, what the hell, I have to speak again in front of okay? So now, first thing what you have to do is, it's an opportunity to prove myself. Okay? Now, do some positive self-talk. No, I am a great speaker. Right now, you have to do. You do it, start doing it right now. First thing is, it's an opportunity. Now, second thing is, I am a great speaker. I'm going to rock the stage. I'm going to speak from my heart. I'm going with a service attitude. Who damn cares what is thinking? Who is thinking what? I don't care, you know? And it's, you know, I'm excited to speak. Yes? Do this. Be ready. Get yourself ready. Okay? And you will get 2 minutes. Okay? First of all, you have to write the, you know, label of your fear, percentage of your fear. When you, not here, when you go on the stage, what is the level of fear you feel? You have to write on a piece of paper, and then you have to now give a speech for 2 minutes of any of your past experiences. Okay? When you went for a marriage ceremony, or you went on a vacation with your family, that experience you have to tell. So, who is going first now? Who is going first? Who is going first? 2 minutes. Who is going first? Share your one-off experience. Who is going first?
Sam, sir.
Yes, Mr. Suresh. Clap for him. I was looking towards you only because I knew you will go. So rest of you, you know, focus here also and implement all the things which you have learned in your mind. One by one, implement. So that you will never forget it. You are making it automatic in your mind right now by practicing it. Okay? So Mr. Suresh, clap for him. 2 minutes. Please go ahead.
Hi friends. Thank you for this opportunity to share my experiences. I am Suresh from Tamil Nadu. I am doing network marketing business for the past 10 years. Mm-hmm. Before 10 years, I am doing some other business. I go one meeting for the opportunity program. I saw some one day in the stage, very excited they are speaking. I am this much, I should develop. They tell me in network marketing only you can earn money and you can self-development, motivation and happiness, health, wealth, all these things come to in this business. So I saw that program, I am very much excited and joined in the business. Slowly, I am follow that leader footpath. Then I am one time I am willing to speak on the stage. Before that, I am very shy to speak on the stage. I am eager to speak on the stage. First time I went to stage and tell the benefit of the product, I see the audience, simply I got complete blind. Nothing will do. My leg is shaking. I'm not showing it. That my leader will notice that and give me a hug and tell me about yourself, where you coming from, what are you studying, what is your qualification, like that. Slowly I am a bit nervous, normal, and give the presentation 10 years back. After that, every time I go stage, I want to talk to people. Came to me an interesting part of my life. In Tamil Nadu, we are usually talk in Tamil slowly, but a little bit English is difficult, so I am not able to convey flow, that's all. After one meeting in a leadership program, first time you go and speak there, you are a leader, you are a team leader, like that, blah, 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 you are a achiever, like that, you are a car achiever. Then I get a bit nervous. In a group of 50 people, I can able to talk. But in a group of 500 people, a little bit nervous. After I complete the speech of 10 minutes, a little bit the experience of my journey, that's all. After I complete the speech in the 500 people, then my mind thinking, one day I will talk to 5,000 people. That opportunity also came to me before 2 years. In Bangalore, I spoke to 5,000 people. In between, I spoke to my experience in that. Now I want, my dream is wanted to speak before 1 lakh people with a very powerful excitement speech for me only. It's not an affirmation from people. It is from me. I want to deliver that like. This is the opportunity to develop that skill. So I came here and see Kaushik sir in Facebook. I am following the Kaushik sir where, when he is where they are land, everything I have followed the Kaushik, and lot of people I am following, but I decided to come with Kaushik sir program. Now I am here to deliver my experience. Thank you for the opportunity.
Super awesome, super awesome. Now you can everyone please, Mrs. Parmeshwari, you are not visible. Mrs. Parmeshwari, yeah, so Mr. Chaitanya, now can you, all of you have seen him giving a speech right now. What do you think, Mr. Yes. Suresh, show your that paper which you have written the fear. What is the percentage? Show here on the camera.
Can't understand, sir. Repeat one second. Repeat.
Show the paper which you have written the percentage of your fear in the camera. No, more closer. 30%. 30%.
Yeah.
Now, how all of you, how much percent you notice the fear according to you, Mrs. Chetu Singhi, yeah, and Mrs. Parmeshwari, what is the percent you notice that he was fearful?
No.
Till what percent? Sorry.
I don't find any percentage. No. He was doing it very nicely.
Mrs. Parmeshwari?
Zero percent.
Actually, people only notice 10% fear. People only notice 10% fear. Okay. And how much percent you think English is problem? He is more focused towards English. My English is bad and all. No problem?
No problem with the English.
So, people only notice 10%. They are not... They also have their life. They are not focusing what, why you are moving and all that. Okay. People only see 10%. What it means is, if you are 100% nervous, people will notice 10%. But when you are 50% nervous, people will notice 0%. When you are 30% nervous, people will notice very great speaker. When you are 10% nervous, you become Tony Robbins. Okay? Got it? So this is another technique. You have to remember that people notice only very less. Right now you saw the example, right?
Yeah.
Now
yeah.
Who is going next? Who is going next? Who is going next? Are Chaitanya is gone. Okay, who is going next? Mrs. Chetu. Yeah, Mrs. Chetu Singhi, clap for her, please, everyone, clap. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Hello, everyone. Myself, Chetu Singhi. I love to make the people fit and healthy with their mind, body, and soul. So, my motto is basically to spread the knowledge. So, I'll share my one experience. Generally, I'm very comfortable with one-to-one clients and giving details to them. So it's basically a business like from one customer side of view, we generally take. So now the portfolio, I wanted to do grow my business. So I joined many corporates and schools and colleges. So I wanted to share one experience of mine. So once there was a big hospital in Calcutta, Ruby Hospital. So I had one first seminar over there with the lots of doctors there. So I was just seeing mine was the third one of speaking the audience with them. So I saw each and every doctor was showing so many slides and talking very, very interestingly, telling the regarding the medical issues and all. So I find it like how to go with it because that was my first experience to narrate with the audience. So I'll start when my turn comes up. So that was my first mistake. I told you what sir has told us in the last one. Don't show your nervousness. I did show it that way. I start with my PPT and I ran very fast. But the last point was when the person start communicating with me. So I find it more comfortable. And I think I have crossed the limit of my timing hours because there were so many queries and I was easily able to handle it. Rather than going with the subject that I was running with the things, I find it more comfortable with the interaction. So whenever I have the webinar, so I try not to give the PPT or to give the PPT for a small hour. I make it more interactive in a talk show kind of. So which I find is it has been limited to some many people because if it is I have 100 audience or 200 audience, that is okay. And when I go for a huge, agar main large amount ke liye jaati hun, so what is the thing behind what I go with it? So that comes in fast. Sabse pehle ye mind mein aata hai. And second point ye aata hai ki how to give them the knowledge because they are not so much trained in the medical field and medical terms. So wo banane ke liye, I find it a little bit tough to narrate to the different category of the people. Because when I'm going to the schools, there are different categories. When I go to the corporate, there is different category. When I go to the hospital, there is different category. So sometimes all of the sudden, I don't know how to do with the things. So this was my first experience, but that was the first experience. Now doing the webinars, the thing is I do it at talk shows, random talk shows. Generally, I do it. I don't take the topics. Generally, I don't take the topics. So whichever person wanted to ask me regarding any of the problem, I do it that way. Not with the theoretical part of the things because I find it much boring sometimes. So I find it might be my audience are finding it more tougher. So this is the general scene which comes to me with it. That's it.
Clap for it. So show me your percentage.
40%.
40%. Again, I think yeah. it will be 0%. Again, it will be 0%, right? Yes, Mr. Suresh, how much you are able to guess the fear?
50%.
50% fear.
For this madam or?
Madam. Madam.
Yeah, I think it will be 40 to 50. I think
fear.
So.
Fear.
He is nice. She is not showing the fear, but in the mind, she is having the fear 40 to 50%, I think so.
No, mind, right? We don't have to. See, you cannot think like a psychologist. You have to see like an audience. You have to see like an audience.
In that angle, there is no fear, 20%.
There is 40. No fear, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
So people, yeah. Are, if you have 40, 30%, there will be no fear. So I think okay. Tanya is driving. So Mrs. Parameshwari, you know, you have to go
now
ahead.
In front of you, it is good.
Yes. Only problem I found in Chetu Singh is, you know, little bit maybe English. That's it.
Yeah, yeah.
Little bit, that's it. So that can be improved by talking more and more. That is the only way. If you want to improve any language, you have to speak. There is no other way. So more you speak, but I find 0%, you know, fear, Chetu Singhi, in your speech. There is no fear. Okay. So again, Mrs. Parameshwari, always delighted, smiling, happy, lot of energy. I can see you. No, now it's your turn. Go ahead and give your, you know, experience, one of experience, share with us, you know, which, you know, and then we will see. Okay. Clap for her.
Hello, everyone. I am Parameshwari, development officer from Puttoro, working since past 10 years. I am working as a LIC development officer. Before that, I am working as a teacher and LIC advisor. That time, I feel that I want to be a great speaker, and from that onwards, I am searching the people. And I am interested to show the opportunity wherever you speak to. The health, the insurance is very important for everyone. It protects the health. When I went to stage, nearly 10 or 20 people, I afraid to talk. Then after practicing little bit every day, I am getting I am afraid to talk, sir.
No problem. Relax and feel like, you know, you have got one opportunity. Just think like you have got one opportunity and you are going to rock the stage. Simply say about your experience. No, just remember, speak from the heart. You are saying your experience. That's it. Okay. You are sharing one story to us. That's it. Okay. Go ahead, please. Actually, I think your internet is also a little bit slow. That's why some problem is there.
Yes, sir.
No problem. You can go ahead. You are doing it very well. You know, we can see that how, you know, energetic you are. And energy is one of the main thing.
June, I am sharing with our club program. June 20th, 2020, our LIC tablet program. That day, actually, I don't know how to dance and everything. But and before 5 years back, I met the accident also. One leg broken and that meant with the surgery. But oh. I am very interested in dance and and other cultural program also. So my friends forced me to dance with. So I practiced just 3 or 4 days. I practiced along with them. And that club day I danced. Then all the people told, I am afraid. See, I am not dancing very well like that. And my leg also not good like that I am feeling. But after the dance, everyone told, you did well. But your leg is not... well, like that also, it is not observed. They seen only how you dance and that also. So from that, I feel like that they are not observing how you, your leg or how you are, but they observe how you, along with they not notice our, this one, what you told. Any language mistake or other communication mistake, how you speak, that one only they observe, that I observe. From that onwards, wherever opportunity is there, whether it is right or wrong, I go to the stage, I meet the so many peoples also, and college lectures also, I go to everywhere in the field. That is my way. Not knowingly, I met with every day nearly 100 or 200 people like that. I speak along with them. Thank you for the giving the opportunity.
So you are already implementing, you are taking it already as opportunity. And again, I can say that everyone's English is same here. Don't worry about the language, because if people are able to understand what you are saying, that language doesn't matter. Do you know Narendra Modi? Okay. That guy doesn't speak English, always Hindi. He goes to many countries, many places, he will speak in Hindi. Now, you know, he is one of the strongest leaders in the world. Whether you believe it or not, it doesn't matter. He is strongest leader in the world. Everyone is following him.
Yeah, yeah.
Everyone is following him across the world. Every leader consider him is the number one leader in the world. He doesn't speak English. You speak
sir,
English.
Today only I speak English before four people. First time.
But never I. Your English is much better. Your English is much better.
Never I spoke English in public places.
There is no problem in your English. It is wonderful. Everyone's English. Mrs. Pameswari, Chetu Singhi, Suresh, everyone's English is wonderful. Okay? So can you show the percentage what you have written? Fear, which you feel? No. Bring it to the camera. Bring it to the camera.
Initial wise.
Okay, you tell what? 50. But actually there is no fear again. Because if you have 50%, okay, then people will not notice it. There is no fear. Yes?
But we feel like that because some mistake is done and some forgotten is there.
But when you implement the learn technique today, okay, there will be no fear. And people, this is another technique, okay? This one, people are noticing only 10% of what you are fearful. What your mind thinks is, they are noticing 100%. Okay? What your mind thinks is, they are knowing 100%. Okay. But only they are noticing 10%. Okay? Now, Mr. Chaitanya, give it a hand for Mr. Chaitanya. Mr. Chaitanya, it's your turn. You can stop the car for 2 minutes.
Yes.
You can stop the car for 2 minutes. Please don't drive. Please stop the car for 2 minutes. Okay. In a site. And just give a 2 minute any of your experience. You went on a vacation or any marriage ceremony for your cousin, brothers or sister. Okay. And implement all that which you have learned. All the 10 or 11 formula which you have learned. Implement. Take public speaking as an opportunity. Okay. Speak from the heart, go with the service attitude, do some positive self-talk. I'm going to rock the, speech today, and don't worry, be open, speak. That's it. Who damn cares?
My name is Chaitanya.
Give it a big hand, please. Mr. Chaitanya is a businessman. He will be always moving. He is also a business person like you. And he is the from my other batch, which is mental toughness for wealth and success. So he has come from that batch. Mental toughness for wealth and success. I have another program. He is from that batch. So welcome him, please. Okay, you can start. This is the final, speech of the day.
Okay. Can I continue tomorrow, sir? Because I have not.
No, just 1 minute. Just one minute. Anything. Just 1 minute. You have to speak.
Okay. Like topic should be about regarding marriage or
anything. You had breakfast. How you had breakfast today in the morning? What time you got up? And then what you did?
Today morning I woke up at 4:00. I thought to go to some other place in the morning itself, but again I have slept for 2-3 hours. After that I woke up and I took my bath and I started for the journey. Before that I had my breakfast upma and I have started.
Super awesome. So are you implementing all the techniques which you have learned today? Are you able to implement while before speaking? Are you able to remember? So
yeah,
your homework is whatever templates you are getting, these 10 points, you have to go and read it 5 times. Okay.
Yes. Yeah,
sure. Today 5 times you have to read it. Okay. And tomorrow when you will come, I will ask you and one by one, you have to tell all this in sequence, step by step. Okay. public speaking opportunity. Okay, I'm going to rock the stage. I'm going to speak from the heart. You know, public speaking, you know, I am going to express. I'm going to speak from the heart. Okay, all that you have to tell without any agitation. Yes, can we do that tomorrow?
Yeah, I can do it.
Yes. So Mr. Chaitanya has also a problem that whether his English is weak and he should join this course or not. What I think is his English is also very good. Whatever he spoke for 1 minute, it is wonderful. So it is only in your head. Actually, your English is good, but in your head, you are in your head. So you are thinking it is bad, right? So everyone's English is good, right? So improvement is always there. Always you can improve. The more you speak, better will be improvement. Okay, so only know that all of you are, you know, there is a speaker within you and today it has woke up and from tomorrow onwards it will start roaring. Yes, it has started roaring also today only, but from tomorrow onwards you are going to roar. Because from tomorrow onwards more and more practice will be there. Okay, so make sure that, you know, you are there. Don't miss any class because this is a practical class. If you just see the recording, that is not useful. Here you are interacting, you are repeating. But when you see the video, you will not be able to repeat again and again. Yourself, your mind will say, boss, you have a lot of work. What the hell you are doing? But here you have to report. Like Mr. Chaitanya said, can I tell tomorrow? No, you have to tell today, maybe 1 minute, but you have to speak. And always remember, Mr. Chaitanya, this is an opportunity. And the more you will speak, you will become better. And end of the 6 day, you will find like, wow. It is a wonderful course because not only you people are business people, you are successful people. You bring a student who is a dumb and he cannot speak to one person. In 2 days, I challenge you that he will go and speak in front of 10,000 people, lifetime, forever. That kind of course this is. This is not a joke. Yeah, it's a very powerful course, but you have to participate. Whatever is being told, you have to do. Yes? Now, yes, the final thing. So, okay?
Okay.
This is the myth of the nervousness. Whatever just now you learned, this is the myth of nervousness. Our mind thinks is, you know, people will notice 100%, but the people will notice only 10%.
10%.
Only 10% they will notice. Yes? But mind thinks they will notice 100%. This is the myth of nervousness. What is of nervousness? Myth. Yes.
This what is the meat.
Meat of nervousness.
Meat.
Meat.
The nervousness is a myth or a myth?
Meat. M-Y-T-H. Meat.
That I know, but nervousness is myth.
Myth.
Myth is like it is 100% people will notice. People will notice 100% of my fear. But they will notice only 10%. Okay? Don't worry, you will get the templates. Okay? And the last one is shyness. Final. Shyness. Shyness is the feeling of unworthiness. Okay? Shyness is feeling of unworthiness. If someone is feeling shy, simply his mind is thinking that I am not worthy of this. I am not worthy of going and speaking in front of 1,000 people, 500 people. So simply understanding this, that I am worthy of everything. If one person is worthy, I am worthy of all the success, everything in my life, shyness will disappear. Okay, so feel yourself worthy of everything. If one person is worthy, everyone is worthy, because everyone is born with the same capabilities. Okay, don't worry if you don't know language. Do you know Tamil? Awesome. You don't need to learn English. Why? Why you should learn? You are able to communicate. People are able to understand you. If you know English, because you want to take yourself to international level or the level where people don't know Tamil, you learn it. Whatever. You should be able to give the message. I gave you one example. Narendra Modi, he is world's number one leader. Okay? Everyone follows him and he is not able to, you know, he doesn't know English. In United States, he speak in Hindi because he doesn't care, because he knows this secret which you are learning. He knows That language is not the problem. Body language is the problem. Okay? So today you are able to remove the root. What you are able to do? Root. In order to change the fruit, you have to change the what? Root. Yes?
Root.
So suppose you are getting fruit which you don't like. The fruits are bitter, sour today, which is of public speaking. You are not liking this fruit. So this was the root which you removed, which was your mind had created this root. Now today you have removed it. And to go this route deeper, today you have to repeat this, what you have learned, 5 times you have to read and try to remember in your mind. So that tomorrow when you come, you don't need to, you know, I don't have to ask. I know that already you remember. But when you repeat it, you will go deeper and deeper and deeper into your mind. Stronger and stronger the pathways are, and you will never forget in your life this, all these techniques. And even though if you forget one, there is no problem, because there are so many techniques you have learned. Right? If one you forget, there is no problem. There is no problem. You have so many techniques which your mind will remember always. Yeah? So go and read it as many times you can read it and try to repeat in your mind so that you don't forget. Okay? And tomorrow we'll meet with a new chapter. Yeah? Don't worry about tomorrow. Today go and, you know, learn this completely and build a mindset today that public speaking is an opportunity and I am going to rock the stage. Every time I go, I do this. Can we do this?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. So sinus is the last word. Yes. Sinus is the feeling of unworthiness. And before that, the exercise which we did is what? This is a myth of nervousness, which is people will notice my fear 100%. Nervousness 100%. While the truth is, people only notice 10%. You saw the example, right? You saw the example, Mr. Suresh. You said like 40%. Yes, you said 30% and people are saying 0%. Mrs. Chetu Singh, you said 40% and people are saying 0%. Mrs. Pameshwari, again, you are saying, you know, 50% and people are saying 0%. Now, Mr. Chaitanya is gone. We are not able to see his score, but at least he was driving, so I don't want to bother him. Yeah. So someone is driving and, you know, he should not take that much risk. At least he is listening to this. I don't know how he is listening. So actually, you should not miss any day, single day. Okay. If you want me to do in the evening, I will do in the evening. If you are not comfortable, all of you. Okay. But what I believe is morning is good because you can take little longer time. Yeah.
This time is okay, sir.
Yeah. This time is fine. Yeah. Yeah, this is a good time. This time you can learn better because your mind is fresh.
Yeah.
Sir, your mind is fresh. Yeah, Mrs. Pameshwari, you want to say something?
Today and tomorrow is okay, but Monday is office for us. So Monday evening is good, sir.
But already this batch is for morning itself. So I will check with this Mr. Suresh and Mrs. Chetu Singhi what they say. Accordingly, we can plan for evening.
Okay.
Okay. Don't worry. Don't worry.
Monday, because Monday is off.
Don't worry. Even if you don't, if you are not able to come again, whenever we'll do the program again, you can repeat it. Okay. Whoever will miss because of some office reason, they can repeat. But if you just don't come and say that, boss, I had some, you know, personal work, then you cannot repeat it. Yeah. So you don't try to miss it. But if you miss it, you can repeat it. Don't worry. Yeah. So can we leave?
Okay, sir. Bye, sir.
Bye. Take care. Repeat this. Make yourself strong. See that public speaking opportunity. Go and start practicing this. Okay. So in your day-to-day life, you will know every time, you know, just remember that public speaking opportunity and I'm going to rock the stage. Yeah. Can we do this? Rest of all, you will remember. Speak from the heart is simply what? Telling your experience, your story. Okay. Well, your knowledge, your own life from your own life, not something you have read. No. I will tell you my story and you, just like I told you my story, right? I was not able to learn. I was, you know, my mom is shouting at me, why you are not going for milk? Okay. My class teacher is nominated my name for the opening speech on the 15th of August and I'm worried how I will give, right? So it is my own story. Why should I take story of, you know, Warren Buffett, where how he learned public speaking? Warren Buffett, about, you know, he is a very good supporter of public speaking. Yes. So all the best, guys. No, we'll meet tomorrow and have a wonderful day. Enjoy and implement all of this in your day-to-day life. Okay, go out and enjoy and implement this. That is very, you know, when tomorrow you come, you should know all these lines without any hesitation. That is the only way. Yes. Bye bye, Mr. Suresh, Mrs. Kameshwari, Mrs. Chetu Singhi. Bye bye, take care.
Yeah.
You'll get the recording in the group. I'll send the recording in the group of this class. Yes?
Okay.
Bye, take care.